Good morning, everyone. Welcome in online computer classes. Students, already your first chapter, computer languages, is already over, and chapter 4 already started. Even I share you that videos also, I give you video YouTube link also that you can watch it. And that PDF format, chapter 1 and chapter 4, also I given in a PDF format in a WhatsApp group, so that you, everybody, you all got it, okay? Now, from next week, you have a short break. There are no more online classes. After short break, we will start again. That also you know that. So before you go for your this short break, I want to revise lesson 1 again, and because I prepare one online quiz on lesson 1. I know that students, that you are getting bored to watch that different subjects, different videos, and then teachers, they give you the work that you have to write in any notebook or in a previous year notebook. And especially in computer, only you have to watch videos and you have to do work that already I given you, that exercise of chapter 1, then all the boxes and then recap that you have to only write. No practicals. Generally in computer you like practicals more, but now the situation is there that you are at your home. Maybe some they are doing their own laptop or desktop. It is very good, but then also I think that maybe you are little bit getting bored with this only theory and writing. So I prepare one online quiz for you. And if you remember, students, that last year when you were in Form 5, then you gave one online quiz at school. So same way, I prepare one online quiz for you from lesson 1. So before I start and before I give you that how you have to go for that online computer quiz, I want to revise once again that chapter 1 whole. Very quickly I just revise that chapter, I just explain exercise quickly, and then I will show you that how you have to go for your online quiz. Okay, fine. So let's we start first from your textbook only, from chapter 1 only. That you know that already I send you that in a PDF format, I send you that chapter 1, computer languages, okay? And maybe some are that already completed that exercise also, that also with answer I send you in that group, okay? So then also, maybe anyhow that someone that missed that lecture on YouTube, which I shared links in a group, or maybe you have not done your exercise. So quickly, I just give you recap of that lesson 1, and then I will explain that how you have to go for your online computer quiz. Okay, it is very simple. Already you given in the last when you were in Form 5, so you will get it well that how you have to go for it. But before we start for a revision of lesson 1, okay? Yes, students, this is content I taken from that your textbook only, because you are generally used to with a textbook. So I put the whole content from the textbook only, and whatever the important in this chapter, I put it up with a red font. First of all, I start from program. A program is a set of instructions which tells the computer what to do. In detail already all explanation and everything over in this chapter. So just I revise whatever the important in this chapter. Got it? So the process of writing specific instruction in a computer language is called programming. Before also I given you example that students that you learnt flowchart and algorithm in a form file, that specific instruction. Whenever you use a specific instruction in any computer language, then it's called programming. Okay. And each programming language has its own specific rules and syntax. In computer language, there are many different computer languages that you know now better, because already this chapter is over. So in all computer languages, there are specific rules and syntax are there. Okay. Syntax, it means you can see here in a Let's Know More what is the syntax. So you can find out that is see in the boxes that Let's Know More. Syntax are the rules governing the formation of a statement in a programming language. Whatever statements, specific statements you used in your computer language, these statements known as a syntax. Okay, and that statement you have to follow as per that instruction, as per that rules only. Okay, so it is known as a syntax. Now there are four categories of computer languages: first generation, second generation, third generation and fourth generation. Okay, now first generation is considered, or it's regarded as a machine language. So what is a machine language? It is the only language that a computer understands. That many a time I told you girls that a computer understand only machine language. And what is the machine language? That it expressed binary digit 0 and 1. Binary, it means there are two digits. Okay, 0 and 1. So 0 means off and 1 means on. Okay, so this is the machine language. It's that only computer understand this machine language. Fine. Then the second one, it's assembly language. This language uses mnemonic codes or symbols in place of zeros and ones. For example, in the machine language, if the operation code for add is 0010, then its equivalent in the assembly language is add, A-double-E, add, it means addition. Okay, so in this way, assembly language is work. Fine. So there are, I just revised two languages, machine language and assembly language. Machine language use binary codes 0 and 1. Assembly language use mnemonic codes or symbols. Okay. Now next, high level language or third generation language. The features of a high level language: simple and user friendly language. Okay. Language which is machine independent. It means that general people also can easily understand or easily use this high level language. So that's why it is known as a simple and user friendly language, because simple English words and mathematical operators used in this high level language, that's why it is known as a user friendly language. Fine. Okay, but you know that computer understand only machine language. That's why whenever you use high level language or assembly language, it's needed to translate in a machine language, and for that there are two translator programs are used, interpreter and compiler. Now what is an interpreter? This translator program used to convert a high level language program into machine language. It translate it line by line. Yes, whenever the interpreter translator program is there, then it convert that high level language into machine language line by line. Fine. And what is a compiler? Compiler is a translator program used to convert a high level language program into machine language. It translates the whole program at once. So there is a difference between interpreter and compiler. Okay. That I think in detail already explained in before that previous videos also. Okay, so now you know that what is the difference between interpreter and compiler. But you have to remember the simple thing that interpreter, it means that it translate line by line. And compiler, it means it translate the whole program at once. Fine. Now then the next one, fourth generation language, or you can say that 4GL. So what are the features of a fourth generation language? That fourth generation languages are closer to human language than any other high level languages. Fourth generation languages are combination of languages with following features. So there are already four categories that already I revised it. Now the features are given here, languages and the features, their features. Machine. Features of machine language that uses binary codes to depend operators to depict operators and data. It is a machine dependent language, only language directly understood by a computer. Now the features of assembly language: mnemonic codes or symbols instead of a binary numbers, machine, and it is also machine dependent and has to be converted into machine language by translator program or assemblers. Okay, then high level language. The features of high level language: uses English words and mathematical operators, and it is machine independent. That's why it is known as a user friendly, and has to be converted into machine language by translator programs like interpreter and compilers. Okay, then the fourth generation language or 4GL. Features of this language: machine independent, minimal user skills required to obtain results, and application development tool. So these all are features of a different languages that which you already learned, that four categories: machine, assembly, high level, and 4GL language. Fine, okay, understood. Okay, point at a glance that already you know that, but then also just I read at once. Programming is the process of writing specific instruction in a computer language. Machine language is the only language that a computer understand. Translator programs are also known as a assembler. It converts the assembly language program into machine language. Then compiler and interpreter are the two types of translator programs used to convert a high level language program into machine language. The term software was first used by John W. Tukey in 1957. Okay, so the point at a glance, and now exercise. Already students, I give you that exercise, but once again I just want to revise it because I prepare your online quiz from this chapter. Okay, so just go through this whole chapter and even exercise. So definitely you will get a good score in your online computer quiz. Okay, so just we start this exercise. Fill in the blanks. A dash is a set of instructions which tells the computer what to do, and the answer is program. Second one, the development of computer languages can be classified into dash categories. Answer is four categories. Third one, dash language consists of sets of binary numbers 0 and 1. The answer is machine. Okay. Then fourth one, dash was the first interactive computer game, and the answer is Space War. This answer, it is given in a box. Okay. You can find out in Let's Know More fact file, you know that this box is. Then next one. Dash uses simple English words and mathematical operators. Answer is high level language. Then, sorry. Dash language uses mnemonic code or symbols, and the answer is assembly language. Okay, fine. Now, true or false? Okay, students, there is I think that fill in the blanks 7, it is not seen here, but I read that, so you can get the answer. I read from the book, so please you also just go through it. That DES was the first computer language for writing artificial intelligence program, and the answer is LISP, LISP. Okay, because it is not seen here, that is 7 blank. So I just read that blank from the textbook. So you also just go through it. Okay. Now state true or false. The first one, Machine language is the only language which a computer understands, and it is true. Then machine language uses mnemonic codes. It is false because not machine language. Assembly language uses mnemonic codes. Okay. Then the next one. Each programming language has its own specific rules and syntax. It is true. Assembly language is regarded as the first generation language. It is false. Assembly language is regarded as the second generation language, not first. So it is false. Then high level language program to be converted into machine language by translator program. It is true. Then programming is the process of writing specific instruction in a computer language. It is true. Okay. Then application based question. And now I just click on that application based question. Yes. MCQ. Sorry, multiple choice question, MCQ. A program written in the assembly language is called, and the B is the correct option, source program. Then second one, NDES converts a high-level language program into machine language line by line, and the answer is interpreter, C. Okay, the program converted into machine language by the translated program is called object program. And the term software was first used by John W. Tukey. Okay, so this is the MCQ. Okay, now I hope that you got it. This fill in the blanks, true or false, and MCQ. And now I just explain. Quiz. Ready? Okay. So, okay, students. Hope you that you get it. Whatever I just revise that chapter. Fine. Because I want to revise this chapter, because as I already told you that I prepare one online quiz from this chapter. So, you quickly get the answer, and at least you recall that whatever I explained in a previous video set. Then also, before you go for your online quiz, just revise this chapter, just revise that boxes and that exercise part. Okay, it means that I know, students, that you don't have any practical time at your home, so just for you use your laptop or your tablet or your cell phone as for practical work. That's why I arranged this online quiz. Okay, so now I show you that how you have to go for online quiz. Okay, once you understand the steps, and then you go for it. Okay, so just stay with me. Okay. Hope you get it here, that online computer quiz lesson 1. Now I start to show you. Yes, first of all, yes, dear students, I have arranged an online computer quiz for you from lesson 1. There are 15 MCQs and 5 true or false, total 20 questions. Each question has 1 point. So, now I show you the steps that you have to follow for this online quiz. Hope you all will enjoy this. Definitely you will enjoy. Follow the step. First, I am sharing you a link that you have to use to start online quiz. Students, look at here. There is a one link already I given here. And yes, in a bracket, I put that instruction also, that this link will be given in a description box of YouTube video also. Okay, so whenever this video, it will be uploaded. You can see that the same link in the description box. And from there only you have to start your online quiz. Okay? Okay. Now, after that, once you click on that link, which I already show you, then as you click on that link, then you get this type of page. Okay? Here it is written, here in this box it is shown that computer quiz form 6 and enter your name. Students, remember that already same online quiz you given in a form 5 in a school. Okay, same way you have to follow the steps. So here it is written, enter your name in a white box. So that even I show you that with arrow also. There you have to type or you have to enter your name. Okay, fine. Whether you can write in a capital letters, small letters, as per your choice, but you have to enter your name. Fine. Then you have to click on a start button. Got it, students? Understood? Now I show you the next step. Yes, as you click on that start button, you get this quiz. Your quiz will start. Okay. And it's start from that question 1. Maybe it's true or false, or maybe it's MCQ. Okay. Because randomly the question will come. Randomly question will display. Okay. True or false or MCQ. And you have to click whatever the, if the MCQ is there, then you have to choose the correct option from that given 4 option. And you have to click over there. And if the true or false is there, for example, that third one, so true or false, the 2 options are there. You whether it is a true, then you have to click on a true. Whether it is a false, then you have to click on a false. Okay, fine. Then next, yes, at the 20th question, when this is over, then at last, you can see here that submit button. Okay. So, after completing, you have to click on this submit button. Even I show you with this arrow also. Okay. You have to click on a submit button. As you click on a submit button, your online quiz is over. And after click on a submit button, you will get your score. Okay, fine. So, hope you that you will enjoy this online quiz very much. Okay. And yes, I hope that everybody you use this quiz. Yes, students, hope that you all understand that how you have to start your online quiz, okay, from that link. And whenever on a YouTube this video it will be uploaded, you will get the same link in description box. And from that description box only, you have to use this link. You have to click on it and you can start your this online quiz. Okay. So don't forget, go on an online computer quiz and hope that you will enjoy a lot. So all the best. Okay, bye.